So in the last tutorial, we discussed basic output. We discussed things such as, you know, if we declared a string with, you know, we'll call it name equals Zach, and then we would declare, you know, a, let's say an integer value age equals 23, and then let's say we wanted to output that. You know, we could say something like console output C out, the two less than signs, you know, don't forget that. And then we could say name, two less than signs, and then is, that's gonna be a raw string that we are inputting into this output stream right here. Then less than age, less than years old. And then we'll even throw in a new line, end line right there. And when we printed that, you know, if you messed around with this enough, oops, so you saw an error right there. I'm getting an error, and the reason why is because I wasn't paying attention. And I'm sure you caught it as you were watching me, but this right here is an integer, and I accidentally put double quotation marks. So let's take away those double quotation marks, turn this into an integer. There we go. So now we shouldn't get an error whenever we build and run this. So I'm going to build and run it. No errors, and we get the output. Zach is 23 years old. And if you practice this enough, this should seem pretty easy for you to understand. But let's move on to what we're talking about now, and that is input, console input. So if console output is C out, then what do you think console input in is? Well, that's gonna be C in. Okay? And then C out deals with less than. Well, CN deals with greater than. So let's, if you look at the difference between these two, the stream operators, and right now I know you're thinking, wow, I'm going to get those mixed up a lot. Well, believe me, I got them mixed up all the time when I first started programming C++, but I promise you, after lots of practice, you will probably never ever get them mixed up again, because you'll get so used to using the right one. And this is gonna have to be something that you practice a lot though, because it's not something that you can get down, you know, immediately. So you have to remember CN is greater than, C out is less than operator. So how do we use CN though, you know, console input? Well, if you're asking, let's take this out real quick, okay? Actually, no, let's leave this up here, okay? Let's just give us a little bit more space. Let's give us another new line. And then let's do another name. Let's declare another variable. We'll call it string name 2, and we won't give it an actual name. See how we have it? Up here we have it declared as a Zach. We declared name as Zach. Well, right here we're declaring name 2 is nothing. Name 2 isn't holding anything right now. And so what we can do is we can say something like, we're going to output enter name 2. So what we're going to do is basically we're going to have Zach is 23 years old output, and then below that we're going to get an output saying enter name 2. Well, it's asking for you to enter something. So to enter something and to let the user use the keyboard to type in a value, you use CN greater than and then the variable name that you want to hold the input in. So since we're telling them to enter a name, we're going to use this variable to hold the name that they enter. So let's say CN greater than name 2. And what that's going to do is when the user enters in a name, it's going to store whatever he enters into the variable name too. Okay? And then we can say cout. We're going to end a few lines. We're going to say you entered and then name two. Endel. And what this is going to do is whatever I enter in for this right here, cn name two, it's going to output you entered and then whatever name two is holding at that point. So let's test it real quick. Let's build and run this. So if you see, we get Zach is 23 years old. That is the result of this first declaration and output stream that we have going on in this first part of the code that we did at the beginning. But then it says enter name two, and you see a cursor blinking right here. And that shows that the console is waiting for input. So right now we're right here in the code, cn name two. So it's saying enter name two, and the console is waiting for us to input something, and then whatever we input, it's going to store it into name two. Okay? So if we enter, let's say, Jimmy right here, and I hit enter, it'll say you entered Jimmy. Because right here we console output you entered and then name two. And name two is holding the value that we entered into it. And that's where it says you entered Jimmy. So, what happens if we want to do something like int age two? Well, then obviously, since we're declaring age two as an integer, whenever we ask for input, oops, I forgot to change this to age two. Now let's build and run it again. And then, of course, right here, this needs to be age two. And that's where these errors are popping up. So fix that. Let's run it again. So it's asking enter age two. Well, age we declared is an integer, so obviously we need to enter an integer such as 8. I'll say you entered 8. Well, what happens if we enter a character data instead, like B or B39, that's string data? It'll say you entered 0 because basically what's happening is that's not a valid data type, so it's giving us a garbage value right here. So anytime you get a weird value that's not what you're expecting, you might want to go look at your data types that you've declared and make sure that they're matching the input of the user. So what I want you to do is I want you to practice using the CN console input and maybe make you a little script or something, a little program that asks you what your name is and practice entering it in with different data types. For instance, you could declare, character first initial and then character last initial, and then say, console output enter first initial, and then you're going to do a console input first initial, and then see out, and then maybe give yourself some space with some indels in lines, and say, enter second initial. And then you're going to have to do another console input, cn greater than last initial. Initial. And then say C out, and then give yourself some space and say, something along the lines of, your initials are, and then first initial last initial. And then if you run that, I'll say enter first initial, Z, enter second initial, R, your initials are ZR. You just kind of practice doing something like that, you know? Entering different data, make sure you're declaring your data types right, and make sure you can mix your input and output and get everything right. You know, practice using these stream operators, because, you know, CN is using greater than, and Cout is using less than. And I would say take a few hours, you know, practicing this and just doing different scenarios. You know, do your initials, a program that asks for initials, and then do one that maybe asks for your address and stuff like that, and just practice entering in data and matching it with your data types.